Welcome back to the show. Today we're going to be building up a kit courtesy of Atlantis Toy and Hobby. They build all their kits in the USA. They reissue. So much nostalgic fun. I just can't handle it. All the kits they push out are so cool looking. We saw this one was going to be coming up this year and I was excited, and they sent it over for a full build. That's what we're going to be doing today. It is the Wright Cyclone Radial engine, the C9HE. It's molded in four colors. Like all Atlantis kits, it's made in the USA. It is a reproduction of a much older kit. It's been re-released a few times. These kits are kind of hard to get a hold of now, and when you do, they're ridiculously expensive. Now you can go and buy the kit and build it and not blow all your birthday money. So let's take a look at everything that will be in the box when you get yours. First up, they love to include extra materials in the boxes. They love to tell you about the kit, include materials that were originally released with the first release of the kit. This one is no different. They've reprinted the Wright Radial Aircraft Engine little booklet. Check that out. It's going to let you know airplanes that it was in, have lists. This is cool. If you like to know a ton about the models you build, if you like to learn, if you like to absorb knowledge, this is a lot of fun to have with your kits. How everything works, the labels of all the proper parts, I'm not going to remember all that, but they can put them in there, and you, those of you who want to, can remember all that. They got the original style manuals. They don't change them. Look at that big exploded view. Then we go into the assemblies. This one does have a cutaway of one of the pistons, so you can see them go up and down. But they are cool looking manuals. Nice exploded views. Show you how to assemble everything, get it all together. This one's quite extensive. They even include, when you get it direct from Atlantis, a 10% off coupon in the box. So when you place your order at AtlantisModels.com, you get 10% off your order. They've got a nice decal in there. They've got the serial number and everything of the engine on there, and then they've got the nameplate for the big stand that it comes with. The stand even has wheels. We'll see that in a little bit. So you get that there. It's a nice metallic decal. The fuel lines, what I'm guessing are the fuel lines, are molded in this flexible vinyl-ish type material. Those are going to go in right here, make that ring, and then come up into each cylinder. That is pretty neat. Molded in four colors, got that nice metallic tone to it. We'll see what we can do with that part right there. I don't know if model glue will adhere with that, but we'll find out as we build. We'll get into the colored styrene. We've got the assembled prop hub with partial props on there. You're going to see some flash-on stuff. Also, the trees are extremely thin, so you're going to have a lot of loose parts in the box. Make sure you don't lose anything. Open the bags carefully. But beautiful molding on there. They've made sure to take care of the molds. Any little bit of flashing you see on stuff like that will slice off very easily. So stop complaining. We'll deal with flash on my model. That's all right. Just have Mom microwave you a Hot Pocket while you scrape the flash off the model. See the back of the prop, parts of the engine housing. Look at all the rivets on there. Nicely done in that gray plastic, so you really wouldn't need to put any paint on this kit if you don't want to. We got the red stand. That definitely doesn't need any paint if you don't want it to have any. Nice big, you can see the size of this kit. 1/12 scale. It's going to be a big, big engine with that prop in there. And then the final parts are molded in black. We got our push rods. Those could use some paint, but you don't have to put paint on any of this. We got what looks like, I think this is the exhaust. I think. Got the insides. I'm going to see how much I can build without painting, if I'm going to paint. And then we've got all of our cylinders. Now the cylinders are numbered individually inside, and you'll probably have numerous that have fallen off the tree, but they've all got numbers inside there. You can see them hiding in there. 9, 8, 11 on the back of that one. See it buried down in there. So just pay attention to those and you'll have the correct parts on there. Nice fin details and everything. Really a sharp looking model. Can't wait to start building it, and that's what I'm going to start doing right now. I'm going to start gluing mine together, and I'll be back. Thank you. Continuing with the build, here's all the different parts I have before I will put them into paint and we'll take a look at them. Now, if you don't want to do an exposed and operating interior of a cylinder, you do have the option of just using this piece, covering it up, and building a full model of your own without any moving parts or anything like that. You don't have to do that. But if you do, you will put that together like so, that one cylinder head, and that will be exposed then. And then you will also assemble the interior piston and make sure it can move freely. And that will install in there, and you'll be able to see it go up and down. And then we have the crankshaft and the pin to turn that. Now I do glue in the crankshaft, but I'm not gonna put any paint on any of these parts here. I will get paint on this one, and then I'll repaint that red by hand because that has plenty of play in it to get a little bit of paint on it and let that piston still move freely inside, so that won't be an issue. But that you can do, these parts here will not get any paint on them at all, so that they still move once they're inside, and then I won't worry about that. Things that aren't getting paint as well, the stand, I still have it clamped together just to let that glue dry for a while and let it sit. That's not gonna get any paint, that's just pressed together back here. So that won't get any paint at all, neither will the nameplate. I don't want to distract from anything, and most of the nameplate's covered with a decal. That will end up sitting on the front, right about there. Let us know what we have. That red is nice and rich. I will clear coat it, and I'll handle that, but otherwise I'll leave the landing gear legs and the wheels. I glued the wheels into place, and we'll put all that together at the end with some super glue. You have pins here that you can remove to tilt the engine forward and back, and it sits nicely as it is in friction, so that we won't be worrying about any paint. What we will be painting is this beautiful prop assembly. We're gonna get to experiment with a lot of metallics on this one. We got our carburation, so I'll get in that. We got what I said, I'm pretty sure is exhaust or something like that. I didn't look up the name of it, but it certainly looks like exhaust for all the other intake parts. We've got what they said was the supercharger housing. Now that will also have parts like the starter and the generator, but those will be black, so I will leave them as they are. We'll get all that metallic, and then we'll put the black parts in it. We'll press those in. We've got our actual block of the engine, or what I'll call the block. I'll be painting that. Then each cylinder will be glued in directionally. There are large tabs, half moons. You can't put them on the wrong way. And each cylinder will get super glued to the top. That will hold in nice and tight. If you're going to be using the operational engine, you can see that hole there. That hole is what the piston will end up going through when we put our cylinder on, like that. And that's how it will look. And then as it goes around on the inside with that little crank by hand, the piston will move up and down in the cylinder on the outside of the engine. So that's why they have that one unique one, is if you want to do it, that's the one you have to attach this one to when you're all done. So don't make that mistake. Don't glue this in a different spot. You also have to make sure you line that hole up like I showed with the hole in the top of the crankcase halves. Then we've got this housing here with a couple caps glued on it. We've got this large part here with the wings and the two halves glued together. We can get that metallicized and add a little detail to it. We've got all the other cylinders which just glue together front and back. We can get those a metallic tone. We've got our push rods. I can't wait to get some chrome paint on those. Those will stand out nicely. And then the fuel parts here, I just went through with a knife and cleaned up the flash on the vinyl. And we'll use those as is. We'll bend those into place on all the parts, insert them, super glue them where they need to be, and then possibly do some touch up with some paint as we go around on there. So that is it. That's all the parts for this thing. It seems like a lot when you look at it, but it really isn't. So I'm gonna start hitting the paint booth and I'll see you over there. Welcome back. We've got the final of Atlantis's awesome Wright Cyclone radial engine, the C9HE. This thing is a beautiful kit. And while you might think building an engine like that, I mean, look at this thing. It looks like real metal. It looks like the real engine, 1/12 of the normal size. You'd think this would be all complicated with all the plumbing, the wiring, and all this stuff going on, but it's not. This kit could be a first-time glue kit. I'm not joking. I'm not exaggerating. This kit could easily be a first-time glue kit. It goes together that well. It's that well designed. The locator pins and holes, when you saw during the extended assembly section, let you assemble this easily and have a nice time doing it. You wouldn't even have to put a drop of paint on the thing. Now, I wanted to paint it up, make it look like ones I've seen online. What I noticed online when I Googled it is there are numerous different colors to these engines. I thought they might all look the same. Well, no. Some look just like this one on the box. Some look just like the box art picture on the side. There's one over here. Some look metallic like that, like I've done it. Some have the nose up here painted in like a sea green color. Some have black cylinders and a metallic front end. Some have metallic cylinders and a black propeller. It doesn't really matter. Pick a design you like or a mix of them and build your engine. Now, I like experimenting with metallics out of the spray can so you can see all the different tones and textures in the engine. We got our exhaust in the charcoal. We got aluminum, flat aluminum cylinders. Then we've got like a dark steel. And then I did some brush painting. We got that antique bronze on the carburetor back there. We've got shiny aluminum. We've got chrome for the push rods, shiny aluminum for the prop with some black accents, and then red where the cutoff is. We did red on the inside of the cylinder where the piston goes up and down so you notice it more. They do that a lot. Left the stand as red plastic so you can really see the variations available on this kit and enjoy them. I certainly did. The vinyl parts just press fit in. If you have a little bit of an issue, you can super glue them, but I only needed to do that on a couple of them. This is way better design than I thought. Nice feature. The prop just fits loosely on the prop shaft, so you can take it off. You could display the engine as is. And when you do that, you can use that in turn and watch that piston up and down it goes. Everything works on it like it should. And then you can put it right back on there and display it with the prop on it. That's such a cool model. I love kits like this. I'm really glad that we have a partnership with Atlantis and they sent this over for a review. Kits like this just get me excited because they're different, they're unique. It's still an engine for the car guys that I only build muscle cars. Fine, that's cool, you build whatever you like. But if you want to step out of your comfort zone and have something on the shelf that looks awesome, this is it. And the aircraft guys are going to love this. The museum kind of guys, the STEM folks trying to teach kids about engines. Don't forget, you get the little pamphlet inside, the 8-page pamphlet. You get to see the piston move. Or if you want to fully enclose that piston, don't forget, you can do that. Either way, you build this up and any way you paint it and decorate it is going to look spectacular. Thanks to Atlantis for sending this over for review. I had a lot of fun building it up. I hope you will too. This is available right now, and I will link to it on their website. And we'll see all of you at the next review.